Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. Today I am going to talk about 4-stroke piston. In today topic I will cover what are the material is used and why it is used, and after that I will talk about the thermal expansion of piston, and after that I will talk about the piston cooling arrangement of the 4-stroke piston. Okay, and after that I will talk about the gudgeon pin. So these all topic we will cover today. So let's begin the video with material of piston. So the first 4-stroke piston material generally consists of three parts: piston crown, piston skirt and piston groove. The piston crown is made up of alloy steel with chromium, nickel and molybdenum for high capacity 4-stroke engine, but for medium capacity engine silicon aluminium alloy is used. Okay, the piston skirt is made up for high capacity and for medium capacity of silicon aluminium, and in lower power engine the piston skirt is also made up of cast iron in some cases, and the piston groove for high capacity is chromium plated as it is subjected to high power and repeated in an outward movement and banging effect. For that it need to be chromium plated. Now the question which has been asked in exam of MEO class 4 and class 2 is that why cast iron is not used for piston crown. So basically because of the high inertia load, higher stress will be acting on the bearing as well as on the bearing bolt during stress reversal in medium speed engine. So basically what here I am trying to say is that as the cast iron having a high inertia means during the change of the movement from TDC to BDC, okay, the load or stress acting on the bearing during the change in the from TDC to BDC or during the power stroke and exhaust stroke during the stress reversal, the stress acting on the bearing bolt and the bearing will be higher if we are using piston crown made up of cast iron. So our main aim here is to keep the crown of such a material which is lighter in nature so that the stress will be much lesser on the bearing as well as on the bolt. Okay. Now second question is asked that okay, we are not using cast iron, but as you can see in high capacity we are switching to alloy steel, as in the case of 2-stroke we are same using alloy steel with chromium, nickel and molybdenum. Why we are not using aluminium alloy, and why we are using aluminium alloy medium capacity you can say also. So for that I have to show you this thermal expansion of piston. Basically when the piston is cold, is that time suppose this is the liner, this box suppose is the liner, okay, and this is the piston when it is cold and this is when it is hot. Like suppose this is the space taken by at room temperature by piston, and this is the space taken by piston crown when it is high temperature or operating temperature. Now as you can see here, the change in space is very high when it is in cold and hot, means the thermal expansion, this is called thermal expansion. The thermal expansion of the aluminium means the coefficient of thermal expansion of aluminium alloy is much higher than the alloy of steel. What do I mean by that? It means by that aluminium alloy expand much more as compared to the alloy steel. Suppose if the aluminium means alloy steel is taking little bit of thermal expansion, the aluminium alloy will take much more than that. For that reason we are switching to alloy steel at higher capacity and we are using aluminium alloy in lower capacity. But now second question is that why we are using aluminium alloy then in medium capacity, why we are not using alloy steel also in medium capacity. We are using aluminium alloy because aluminium alloy has the advantage that it is lighter in nature and it is mainly lighter in nature. For that reason we are using aluminium alloy. But and we are not using aluminium alloy steel in medium capacity because of the cost, higher cost of construction. We are not using aluminium alloy steel in medium capacity. I hope you understand why all the questions related to construction. Now let's move to the cooling. How the cooling is done in four stroke piston? Basically, this is the oil coming to connecting rod. So first let me tell you how the oil is coming. The oil is coming from main bearing through a drill passage in the crankcase to bottom end bearing. After that, through a hole in the con rod, the oil is coming up, and as it is coming up, it is filling up this gudgeon pin space, and through a hole in the gudgeon pin, it is climbing up, and as it climbs up, there is slot provided on the lower surface or the inner surface of ground where the oil will flow and will cool the surface and will come down like this and will through a skirt it will return to the crankcase. So this arrangement which you can see is the arrangement for a high capacity four stroke piston. In lower capacity what happened mainly, the oil cooling means the piston crown is cooled by a splash, means the oil is being taken by the crank throw and splash on the inner surface, on the under surface of the piston crown, means here it will be splashed and that amount of heat will be taken by the conduction. So that is used in a medium capacity. Okay, now as you can see here, this is the floating gudgeon pin, means this part is mainly this area. Okay, so the oil is coming here and it is filling up the space, and after filling up the space it is going up for the piston crown cooling. As it is filling up the space, the gudgeon pin is basically shrink fitted, or you can say it is clearance fit. Okay, for that I have written you gudgeon pin is a clearance fit in the skirt and retained by circlip or a end plate. Okay, so the lube oil film on the either side of the gudgeon pin causes it to as if to float because of the hydrodynamic lubrication. So this is called floating gudgeon pin and also causes the lubrication. Okay, so here it is been held up by circlip and the oil is returning through the here. Okay, so I hope you understand the piston cooling, thermal expansion and a four stroke piston construction. I hope you like the video. Please subscribe and please share. By the subscription you will give me the motivation to continue with this type of video. Please share, and if you like it, email credit goes to mahindiesel.uk. Thank you, friend.